The supermarket duopoly is once again in the Commerce Commission's sights, this time over misleading pricing, promotions and specials. And the government says it's looking at ways to increase competition. But it won't go as far as promising a third supermarket chain is on the way. Business correspondent Katie Bradford reports.
It's easy to feel a bit ripped off after a visit to the supermarket. Now the Commerce Commission is investigating whether that sentiment is real.
You know when they put the yellow stickers on and you go up to the checkout, and when you go up there they're actually charging you full price and not actually the yellow sticker, and it happens on actually quite a range of items.
My parents are super vigilant with receipts and things like that. Definitely happened to them before.
I think a couple of times I've like looked at something and the special was like more expensive than the original price.
I don't know if they do it intentionally, but maybe they're tricky about it.
ConsumerNZ crowdsourced examples of misleading promotions, prices and specials and received over 600 complaints. They handed those to the Commerce Commission, who are now investigating Woolworths and Foodstuffs. So, when is a special not a special? Well, it seems obvious when you look at these examples. A reduced price on chicken mince, that's actually 31 cents dearer. Or a promo on two drinks for $7 when it's cheaper to buy individually.
We're really interested to see what the Commission makes of it and whether, in fact, you know, this is a breach of the Fair Trading Act.
If it is found to be a breach, they face fines of up to $600,000 per offence.
We have a real problem with the paltry fines that the courts are imposing under the Fair Trading Act. We'd hope, if this case got to a prosecution, that a decent fine would be levied.
From a corporate perspective, it's not only the fine, it's the branding issue that comes with a prosecution. And we are considering the level of penalties, but we haven't come to a firm view on it.
The new government's looking at other options for forcing supermarkets to be more competitive, including giving increased powers to the Grocery Commissioner.
We need to provide the framework, the environment for a third-party operator to come in. Governments can't just sit there and go and find a third-party operator. That's not the role of government. Our role as for government is to set it up so that people can come in if they want to take a risk.
Neither Foodstuffs or Woolworths were willing to comment on this investigation, both saying they will cooperate fully. The cost of food has started coming down, now up to supermarkets to make sure it shows on the shelves too.
Speaking of the cost of food, Katie, tomorrow we see the latest inflation figures. What can we expect?
Looks like we may be getting some good news that inflation will keep going down. You might have seen it this summer as you drove around. Petrol prices a bit cheaper, food prices down in some areas as well. So that track of going down, inflation may go under 5% tomorrow. That's well off those highs of close to 8% we saw about a year ago, but not within the Reserve Bank's target of 1% to 3%. And for that reason, when it comes to interest rates, those high interest rates we're seeing, the Reserve Bank's probably going to want things to keep tracking it like this for a few more months before we start seeing the official cash rate and interest rates going down. At this rate, though, if things do stay as they are, maybe towards the end of the year, those rates will come down.
And the Reserve Bank's also looking at making some other changes for would-be home buyers.
Well, the Reserve Bank for some time has been talking about wanting to introduce debt-to-income ratios. Basically, this is another tool in its toolbox to stop people getting into too much trouble when things go wrong. Now, debt-to-income ratio is when banks assess basically how much you earn. If the debt-to-income ratio is set at 6, you can only borrow up to 6 times your income. That's what the Reserve Bank's suggesting setting it at for owner-occupiers, a debt-to-income ratio of 7 for investors, and banks will only be able to set out 20% of their lending for people with ratios that high. Look, it's not that much of a problem at the moment. Banks aren't lending that amount of money in huge amounts at the moment, but what the Reserve Bank wants to do is to protect against when we see times like we have where house prices start going down, interest rates going up, people can't afford the amount of money they've borrowed. It's all about protecting people from getting into too much trouble. It'll go alongside to the current loan-to-value restrictions, and it'll consultations still going out for people to have their say on these proposals. If they come in, it'll be in a few months' time.
You're looking for a mortgage, DTIs and LVR.
You've got, there's a lot of words there, a lot of jargon there, word soup there. But it really is, as I said, about protecting people from getting into trouble.
Katie, thanks very much for that.